Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to take a simple example of sheet metal in Autodesk Inventor, and here we will create this simple model and we will learn some basic commands of sheet metal, and then later we will see how to import this one in drawing and create a simple drawing for this. At the left hand side we have all three views or flat pattern drawing. So I hope you like it. So let's start to make this simple exercise in Autodesk Inventor 2017. We are going to practice a simple sheet metal exercise in Autodesk Inventor. So let's start. Click here new. Once you comes here, just choose sheet metal. Here we have two dimensions, DIN and millimeter. So we will choose millimeter and select grade. This is the interface, Autodesk Inventor interface. So here sheet metal toggle open. So we will start with one simple sketch. So either you can choose any plane from here, or even though simply select create 2D sketch. Now see here, too many planes. Let's start with XZ plane, and here we will select center rectangle. Now let's say 30 millimeter, press tab key, 35 millimeter, enter. Now simply finish sketch. Now this is our sketch. Let's go to sheet metal tool. Here you will see too many options in sheet metal. So first option, we will start face. If we select face, here profile you need to select. Here profile already selected. Now here you will notice they didn't mention the dimension for thickness. So I'll show you, you have to change or previously input the dimensions on a default set. Now here it is, see new solid, because there is no previous body, so it will not select join, it will select new body. Okay. Now see here thickness. If you want to change the thickness for this sheet metal default, and here select this pencil, and here you can create new and give any name like 2 millimeter, and you can create a file folder and keep as default, but we will not do this one. We will simply select use thickness from rule. This is 0.5. if you choose 1 millimeter, apply. Now see, thickness is increases, but 0.5 is enough for this job. Apply 0.5, cancel, that's it. Now next part tool is flange. With the help of flange you can create up and down any flange. If you choose up, see it goes up, hold shift key and again select this line and it will deselect. Select bottom, see it's going bottom, and distance here either 2 or distance. We have only one option right now, so we will choose distance 12 millimeter. Now bending angle, bending angle you can change like 45 degree, minus 45 degree, whatever angle you like, 90 degree. Now here bend radius. Now height of datum. Height of datum means the dimension of this from where. So the first option is bend from intersection of two outer, so the sharp edge of these two is going to take the dimension. Now the second dimension, it is only this bending length you are going to take dimension, and third one is from the radius of dimension going to take the center point of this and the end point of this. And here bend position, if you saw this first one is inside of bend face. If you select out bend from adjacent face, see this is the going to take the bending from outer face of this sheet. If we choose, there is one outside of base face extend. This is the middle things, your dimension going to take the center point of this radius, and this one is tangent face, but we don't have option this one, so I can't tell you. First inside, this one is better option. Now let me rotate. Now here click add and I'll select this one. Now see, okay, now here we created two bends. Now let me create one more bends flange and I'll choose this bend 12 millimeter, but here we want to do some modification. So here we have one option, bend. Okay, just click on this icon, bend icon. Here you will see we will keep everything same, 12 millimeter bending position inside of bend, and the length also, height of also from intersection point. Select this one. If we choose this one, check here, you have too many options. So this one, now see width, whatever width you have, either offset or either center. Center, let's say 20. See, it's increased. Okay, we have one more option, offset. Offset is going to take the distance from both the sides, so this is not perfect thing. Width is better option. We will see in later on other options. Okay, see, now what we want to see for this, we want to see this bending from inside. Either you can keep from outside also, but if we keep inside, you will get one corner bend. You will see these kinds of corner here, and these kinds of corners are default. Okay, now look, see, this is the corner. Now the next thing we will see here, lofted things we will learn later, hemming. Now hemming we will choose. So here we will choose this face. Just now first option we selected shape, then select flip direction, either which direction you like to keep. See, now the gap between these two, either you can change, let's say thickness into 1 millimeter. Now gap change. Now length of this, so let's say 10 millimeter. See, and let's keep this 5 millimeter only. And here also we have too many options. There are four options, not too many. Double folded, then rolled, single and torch, but the single is for today's tutorial, even though let's take it inside. Okay, see, now lofted bend, fold drive, these things we will see later. Then fold unfold we will see. Let's say unfold, it will first ask you stationary reference plane, so we will select this one. Now you will see it is calculated and found this much bending. If you select add all bends, see, it will show you preview. Okay, now it's open. Now let me choose this face sketch, and here draw any sketch you like to keep, center rectangle. Let's say this one 4 millimeter, tab 10 millimeter, enter. Let me draw two circles here. Two millimeter. Let's make the gap. Millimeter. Now here distance, millimeter, even though let's reduce 6 millimeter. this point. Now see, this is comes in one line, and if you choose again this point and this point, and this is by default same. So now finish your sketch, and here go to 3D model and choose here extrude. Now by default the selected, or otherwise you can simply select this one, and here select cut. See here, now if we select cut, it will automatically cut, and here choose extend all. If you choose all, it will cut only up to thickness. But that's it. Now let's try next command. Go to sheet metal, refold, stationary reference, select this, add all bends, click here. Now see, it will automatically calculate and select all the bends. Now see, now if you want to see some more things here, like hole, let me choose this face, select front view. Now here we will see today linear. Now face already selected, the reference plane. So first line we will select this top, select 6 millimeter. Second line it will ask you select this, so 10 millimeter. And here we will choose hole 3 millimeter, and select through all, so that it will make throughout hole. Okay, now rectangular, let me choose this hole here, and for direction let's say this one, and see this coming here, two number of patterns, distance 10 millimeter in only one direction. See, in one part we selected the hole, and second no need, direction we selected this one, number of patterns we need two hole, so one and two, distance 10 millimeter. Now see, now let's say corner round 3 millimeter, let me choose select 1, 2, 3. If you move your cursor, you will find here. Okay, so all 3 millimeter. So now even though if you want to see the flat pattern, simply here you will find create flat pattern, select, and see this is your flat pattern. If you want to create a drawing for this, just first save this one part, any part name, wherever. Okay, it is asking it will not save you flat mode, so simply go to folded. Now save, save. Now click here. Now if it comes down here, you will see too many options, so we will select here ISO IWD drawing, create. Now once you select, you will see this sheet, select base. Once you select base, here you have two options, either folded or flat pattern, even both you can see. Scale from here you can choose 2 by 1, whatever you like, and okay. Even though again if you want to select, dimensions, okay. Now let's drag it. If this drawing you want to put somewhere like here, so this is your development view. So this one, even though you can go to annotation, use dimension, you can allot dimensions to here. in the same way you can allot all the dimensions. So this is the simple tutorial how to create a 3D model in Autodesk Inventor sheet metal part. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks, Inventor and Fusion 360. Thanks for watching.